Hello everyone, I'd like to share a very brief demo of Wassette. Wassette is a security-oriented runtime that runs WebAssembly components via MCP. Wassette's been a collaboration between the Azure Core upstream team at Microsoft and the Cloud Native and Linux team inside of advocacy, including myself, Aaron, Yosh, and Josh. Wassette enables AI agents such as VS Code and many different terminal UI agents and others to consume WebAssembly components as MCP tools. It provides the ability to load them dynamically, as well as browser-grade isolation of tools via the Runtime security sandbox. So all of these tools are run inside their sandbox. And on top of that, we provide a granular permissions model, which is very much like the iOS permissions model, which gives you permission for network and other access that for resources that each tool may need. So this provides a great deal of security around the execution of these different tools. Now, these WebAssembly components are generic. They're not specific to Wassette. There's a whole ecosystem out there. Any language which can target WebAssembly and compile down to a WebAssembly component can build a component that can be consumed generically via Wassette, which is incredibly powerful. Yosh has created a blog post called Introducing Wassette WebAssembly-Based Tools for AI Agents when we launched this project back in August. I highly recommend it. It's a great introduction to the project and also some of the rationale behind why we created it. And since then, we've got about 650 GitHub stars. We have a rich community of contributors who have contributed things like samples, demos, have spoken about it, who have fixed bugs and that sort of thing. So there's been a lot of excitement about Wassette. We've gone through a lot of different issues. We've worked through hundreds of pull requests across our team and with external contributors and others, and also with a ton of GitHub Copilot inside of GitHub as well, which has been tremendously powerful for us as well. It's been a great platform for that. We can install inside of macOS, Linux, and Windows. We've got native packages for Winget, Homebrew for macOS and Linux. So the first thing, if you're trying out Wassette, which we're about to show off in the demo here, is to install the Wassette binary on your local machine, and then you install it as an MCP server inside of your AI agent, such as VS Code. We also have support for all of the MCP clients, the popular ones, including terminal UI agents such as Claude Code, Gemini, OpenAI, as well as GitHub Copilot, which has just been released. Now, if we have a look at the installation side of VS Code here, we can see we click open inside VS Code. We're going to install Wassette inside of VS Code, and then you'll be able to see it loaded there with all of its tools. Now, once you have Wassette loaded, we can go through sort of the hello world of Wassette, which is to load a component from an OCI registry. So this is the time component that Yosh has put on his personal OCI registry under Yosh Woods. And I can say, I want to run the load component tool from the Wassette MCP server. And it's going to pull this down from the registry, and we'll be able to run it once it's loaded. So as you can see, the time component has been loaded, and now I can execute that component by saying, what is the current time? And this allows permission to execute that tool and run the component. The next component I'm going to show off is called fetch, which allows us to fetch a URL from the internet. And I'm going to load the fetch component. It's also going to load that from the OCI registry and pull that down. And it's dynamically loaded that tool into VS Code here. And now I'm going to ask it to provide a concise summary of opensource.microsoft.com with this blog post we've done about distributing WebAssembly components using OCI registries. Now we're asking permission to run the tool at the VS Code level. And now it sees that the tool doesn't have network permission to pull down this URL. So next we're going to grant network permission so that we can access that particular URL using the grant network permission tool. And now it's got that permission, it's going to fetch the content again. Next we're going to take a very brief look at Wassette inside of Copilot CLI. So if I open Copilot CLI, I can make sure that I have Wassette pre-installed, which I've done earlier. I can go back. And then if I wanted to run these things in one shot, I could copy all of this as a single prompt and paste that into here. And Copilot CLI will dynamically load and run these tools. It's going to ask permission the first time it uses load component, but I'm going to say yes and approve all tools from the server Wassette for the rest of the running session. Now we could have fine-grained permission tier where we give the ability to load components, but we don't give the ability to grant permission. And there you have it. This is particularly useful inside of agentic loops, where we want to be able to set tools going on tasks, but have them running in a secure way so that we can trust that they're not going to exfiltrate data or do damage in some other way. This helps address a major security challenge inside of the AI agent workspace. We'd love to hear what you think about Wassette. Please try out Wassette from the GitHub repo here. Take a look at the blog post. Let us know what you think.